بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على سيد الأنبياء
حضرت معاوية
أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الناس إنا خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعارفوا إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم إن الله عليم خبير صدق الله العظيم وجعلنا في ابن أبي سفيان رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من يريد الله به خيرا يفقه في الدين أو كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم صدق الله وصدق رسوله النبي الصادق الوعد الأمين. This is a month of Rajab and it is one of the four sacred months that has been assigned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as Ashhur-e-Hurm. This is Rajab and this month is also the famous with the greatest miracle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Mi'raj. Although there are different opinions of the time and the month of Mi'raj al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but the famous among the people is month of Rajab. And this is a month in which one of the great companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam died. And his name is Amir-e-Muawiyah radiyallahu ta'ala. Amir-e-Muawiyah is a great companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam who embraced Islam before the conquer of Makkah al-Mukarramah, before Fath Makkah. And indeed there are different opinion when he embraced Islam, but mostly it is written and it is said by the scholars he embraced Islam in the 7th year after the Hijrah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But he did not disclose, he did not inform due to some reason, and at the time of Fath Makkah, and he declared and that he is a Muslim and he has embraced Islam. Amir-e-Muawiyah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu is a companion. He is called Khalul Mu'mineen, the uncle of the believers, uncle of the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The reason, because his sisters was the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The name was Ramla bint Abi Sufyan and the kunyat was Habiba. And she was the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Amir-e-Muawiyah is famous with the title Katib-e-Wahi. And Katib-e-Wahi, again, one quality that he was able to read and write. This is a great quality. At the time when there were no common practice among the people to learn how to read and write. And even Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that my ummah is ummi. And that they are, ummi means who are not able to read and write. But Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam emphasized on the ummah to read, to learn how to read and write. And even the first verse that revealed upon Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it was Iqra bismi rabbikal ladhi khalaq. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam introduced himself as Muallim, innama bu'ithtu muallima. So one quality of Amir-e-Muawiyah is that he was among the few people who were able to read and write. And the second quality is the confidence of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam upon Amir-e-Muawiyah. So Amir-e-Muawiyah is one of the few people who was trusted by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and appointed as Katib-e-Wahi. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to dictate what he received the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the verses of Quran Kareem. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam dictated to write these verses of Quran Kareem, and one of them was Amir-e-Muawiyah beside other Amir and Muawiyah has the same family that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had. Amir and Muawiyah is the son of Abu Sufyan. Abu Sufyan's name was Safar. Safar bin Umayyah. Safar bin Harb bin Umayyah bin Abd Shams bin Abd Manaf. This is the chain of the family of Amir Muawiyah. So Abd Manaf is the common grandfather of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Sufyan and Amir Muawiyah. So from Abd Manaf, then up, it is the same family, the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So after Abd Manaf, then there were two branches. One is called Hashim, Hashimi, and another is called Banu Umayyah. So Amir Muawiyah belonged to Banu Umayyah. So children of Umayyah. So, but Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has introduced the religion. It has no importance of clan and the tribes. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the Quran Kareem, Inna akramakum indallahi atqakum. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Khayrukum fil jahiliyyah, khayrukum fil Islam. And Abu Sufyan, who was the father of Amir Muawiyah, he was one of the leaders of the tribe of Quraysh in Makkah. And even before Fath-e Makkah, he was the prominent figure of the people of Makkah who were engaged himself, who was engaged himself against to fight Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, against the believers. So, but at the time of Fath-e Makkah, he embraced Islam. The whole family embraced Islam. But his daughter, Umme Habiba, Ramla, embraced Islam in the beginning. And she migrated to Habasha. And again, she migrated to Madina Munawwara. So Muawiyah, رضي الله تعالى عنه, has the great background. And Abu Sufyan and his son, Yazid bin Abi Sufyan and Muawiyah bin Abi Sufyan, these three figures are very important in playing a role in establishing Islamic State. And even Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq appointed Hazrat Zayd ibn Abi Sufyan, who was the brother of Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in the area of Syria. And then Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu appointed Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu as a governor for Jordan. And after the death of Yazid bin Abi Sufyan, Amir Muawiyah was appointed as a governor for Syria, for Dimashq. And then later, in the time of Hazrat Uthman, some more areas were given to Hazrat Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So Hazrat Muawiyah is not only a companion. He is the one who played an important role in establishing Islamic State and at the same time to make the progress, to strengthen Islamic State. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave glad tidings to those who will fight through the sea against oppression, against kuffar. So Amir Muawiyah is the first companion among the companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who made this army, the, you can say the navy in Islam, in Muslim history. So when any person will write the history of Islam, he cannot delete the name of Amir Muawiyah. He cannot make any statement about Islamic history without Amir Muawiyah's role. So that Amir Muawiyah is the one who ruled about 40 years, 20 years as a governor, and 20 years as a head of Islamic State. And Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he was appointed governor, and due to his contribution, due to his capabilities, all were praising Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam make the dua. Amiri Muawiyah رضي الله تعالى عنه and said, Allahumma ja'alhu hadiyan wa mahdiya mahdi bihi. Oh my Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, grant him the guidance and make him guide for the people and give to him guide others. So when we say this is the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have to believe that Allah accepted his dua for Amir Muawiyah. Another important point, Amir al-Mu'mineen Sayyidina Umar bin Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu was the acceptance of the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah accepted the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for Islam in favor of Umar Farooq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And Hazrat Umar appointed Amir Muawiyah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu as a governor. Then Hazrat Usman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu gave more responsibility to Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And when Hazrat Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu was martyred, and he was martyred by the Abdullah ibn Sabah, who was hypocrite, and it was a plan that to kill three important personalities of Islam. And but unfortunately, Hazrat Ali was killed and martyred. After Hazrat Ali al-Murtada radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Hazrat Hassan took the Khilafah and the people made the bayah. And Hazrat Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu remained as a Khalifa. And we believe, and Ahl Sunnah agree on the point, four companions. The time of the four companions, that is the time of Khilafat Rashida, Abu Bakr Siddiq, Umar Farooq, Usman Ghani, and Ali al-Murtaza. But some other scholars says, so any period that is run by a companion of Rasulullah would be considered as Khilafat Rashida. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the companion of Rasulullah, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الرَّاشِدُونَ. So in the light of that, the period of Hazrat Hassan is also the period of Khilafat Rashida. And some scholars say the period of Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu is the period of Khilafat Rashida. So how he become a Khalifa? This is again an important lesson for today's conflict among the Ummah. Hazrat Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu realized that when there is a conflict between the two groups among the Muslims, so the progress cannot be made. Then progress cannot be achieved. No, any single city or the village was conquered in the time of conflict between the Muslims. So Hazrat Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the grandson of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, realized, and he sent the message to Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu that I want to make reconciliation. If you are angry, Hazrat Amir Muawiyah was a great person. He has not sent back the message that I'm ready. He has signed on a blank paper and sent to Hazrat Hassan that if you have given me this offer that I am signing, so it is up to you. Whatever the condition you want to write, I will accept. So Hazrat Hassan and Amir Muawiyah became one group. So as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave the glad tidings about Hazrat Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, فَيُسْلِحُ بَيْنَ فِيَتَيْنِ عَظِيمَتَيْنِ, that my grandson will be a reason of uniting to great jama'at, to great group. So he, Hazrat Hassan, made the bayah on the hand of Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So this is 41 years after the hijrah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From 41 years after the hijrah till the death of Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu in the 60th year after the hijrah. This is about 20 years period. So in this 20 years period, again the Muslim achieved many conquers. And Muslim achieved many areas. And they, Islam spread to the northern Africa and to Central Asia, and to Asian countries, including Kabul, including Central Asian states, and including Europe, some part of the Europe. So this was the achievement of Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And you will be surprised that there is no single incident that could be mentioned in the history that in the time of Amir Muawiyah, Hazrat Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, or Hazrat Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu, or any other companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said anything against Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. This was the time of peace. This was the time of progress. This was the time of prosperity. This was the time of justice. Amir Muawiyah introduced to the world, and what he had the love with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his family. Just imagine, he financially supported Sayyidina Hasan radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, Sayyidina Hussein radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, and he used to give the scholarship and financial support to the companion and the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he had so much love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his heart that he collected some clothing of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, some hair, some nail of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he made the will that at the time of the death, then these nails and hair should be kept on the eyes and forehead and the face of himself. And when Hazrat Muawiyah said, when I'm buried in the grave, so these, the hair of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam should be with him when Hazrat Amir Muawiyah is in the grave. And the clothing of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam should be with the coffin of Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala. This was a great. The people sometimes, they are not realizing that a person today, if he claims that he has brought revolution in some country, and this revolution is successful, when we say about the revolution of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if we say this time or this period was not good in the history of Islam, so it means we are blaming the revolution that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam brought to the world. It was not successful. No, it is the continuation of the progress from the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Abu Bakr Siddiq, Umar, Usman, Ali, Hassan, Muawiyah. So this is the continuation of the time of the progress that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Sahaba has made. So even today, the area that Hazrat Amir Muawiyah conquered, so the people who are praying there, the people who are doing the work of deen, definitely the reward of their good deeds will be given to them who are performing, and will be gone to the reward of Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu also. Because in his time, the area was conquered and came to the flag of Islam. So we have to remember with good words. We have to respect, because if we respect the Sahaba companion, it means we are respecting Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we are disrespecting any companion, it is not allowed. So if there is something written in the history and that is not matching with the statement of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so we have to reject the history and we have to take Quran and the Sunnah. Quran is praising the Sahaba, and Sunnah and Hadith is praising companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we have to respect them. We have to say good words for the companion, and we have to announce the revolution that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam brought. It was continuously made the progress in the time of the Sahaba, and we are proud of that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise the status of Amir Muawiyah in Jannatul Firdaus, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us understanding to understand the life pattern of Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu and his work in a different field. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us understanding and the love with the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Wa ma alayna.